There's one rule about the ocean. You don't turn your back on it because you never know what's really gonna happen. My name is Paddy Mack, and I wanna tell you guys about the time that the wave beat my ass. Been going down there every year since 2008 for the skimboarding contest that they hold down there. And Cabo's known to be a wild time, just the ambiance and everything about the town. Everybody's ready to go, and the waves are no different. This particular beach, it's just a system of cliffs, and that's why these waves are so crazy, because there's no continental shelf, there's no nothing slowing these waves down from the deep ocean swells, and all of the energy is pointed to this particular beach. Everybody's really excited to always head down there for the waves, because they're usually pretty gnarly, and all of the skimboarders, all of my boys, everybody goes down for this contest. The waves that come into, that break on this shore, shake the entire hotel. I mean, you're sleeping in your room and you hear the windows, whoa, 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 you have to put couch cushions up against them. So we're watching and we hear a couple pretty good ones. We're like, let's go down and see what's up. And everybody just immediately gets in the water. There's probably about 10 or 11 of us that are all at this stretch of beach. In this clip, it looks like I'm down at the beach by myself, but no, everybody's having a good time, like at a water park, and I'm the one who fell off the top of the slide. I wanted to try and be the cool guy, so I took the GoPro and I'm finagling it, trying to get it to selfie mode so I can film myself and how big this wave is. And by the time I get it where I need it to be, I turn around and I look, and oh my God. And I realize that I'm not where I should be, and I don't see any of my friends because they all swam out to sea because they're not idiots. And in a split second, as soon as you see me, as soon as you see the wave actually hit, it takes me up. That's not the end. It takes me all the way up about 15 feet in the air. You don't know what orientation you're at. You don't know if you're upside down. You don't know if you're head first, leg first, arm first, shoulder first. And especially if you don't know where you are, how high up, you can't brace yourself. There's a good chance I might drown. I felt weightless and felt like forever, but it was only a couple seconds. And I guess that's what they say. Your mind makes everything super slow motion when it feels like it's in a tragic situation. When I got up, I was okay, and it instantly hit me like, yes, I survived, and I just started screaming, yeah. You're not in control when you're in the ocean, and you never know what's gonna come through.